everybody. Hello. Oh, let's try that again. Hello. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Jazz Sanctuary here with First Congregational Church of Concord. Whether you are joining us in room or live on Facebook, we're so glad that you are here to help us celebrate our favorites today, which many of you helped vote for, which we were very appreciative of. So to start off, since we're basically celebrating, we're going to do a Tim Jazz Sanctuary paraphrase of Psalm 150. You'll note that we all have lines together. Those who identify with the feminine, those who identify with the masculine, the congregation has lines, the band and deacons have lines, we've got some own lines. So just read with us as we do this theatrical version of Psalm 150 together. So we begin together saying, praise the Lord. Praise God in God's sanctuary.
Praise God in God's firmament.
Praise God for God's mighty deeds. Praise God according to God's surpassing greatness.
Praise God with the trumpet sound.
Praise him for the saxophone.
Praise God with the bass.
Nice.
Praise God
for the drums and cymbals. The human voice, 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 human voice. Whatever. Everybody, praise God with voices of celebration. Now we all get to make some noise. Make some noise, make some noise. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well done, everybody. And we'll begin our jazz set with Footprints.
Shorter, who was a very famous composer and jazz saxophone player for many years. Thank you.
Look my way, pretty woman, say you'll stay with me.
just like on Jupiter am I. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, oh baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You were all I long for, all I worship and adore.
Listen.
saxophone player was Cannonball Adderley. He did this song and he did a little bit of preaching here. And he actually got a word from his piano player named Joe Zompadu. Very famous here. He said, "You know, sometimes we're not prepared for adversity. And when it happens, sometimes we caught short. I don't know exactly how to handle it, but when it comes up, sometimes we just don't know what to do when adversity takes over. And I have some advice he got from his piano player, Joe Zompadu. And it sounds like this. It sounds like you should be kind of having this little thing he called, have mercy, mercy me."
Into church. We're good.
Well, we are so glad to have everybody here today in August for our Jazz Sanctuary on Favs. We put out some Facebook and other ways through the church
media of asking people to vote, and we got some votes, and the band voted, and so what we're playing today are our faves. That's one of the reasons. I mean, we're always pretty eclectic, but today is way eclectic.
Really eclectic.
It's all over the map, but that's because it's the stuff that you and many others and all of us have sort of responded to best through the years. So we're glad to have all of you today, and glad to have our amazing musicians as always. We have all the way to my right with his very tasteful black and white jazz shirt today. Mm-hmm. Very nice. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, very nice. On four different instruments and vocals, the man is just a workhorse. Woo! Joey Placenti.
Yes.
We have on drums today our good friend who now lives in Penacook, not Manchester, Chuck Booth. Woo! And the grand musical overlord of all of us, who does everything related to recording and having the sound and the cameras and everything, plus plays his bass and wears a brand new electric shirt birthday present, electric bass shirt, Jock Irvin. And we're delighted, she was away for a little bit, but we're delighted this is the first time back in worship.
Indeed.
That we have our amazing vocalist and pastor, we're so glad she's here today, Amelia Halstead.
Thank you.
We have our jazz deacons here today, as always, Brenda, who's been working her fingers to the bone since, I don't know, early this morning, and Carol and Jean, and so we're glad to have all of our jazz deacons, and Ron is here too. He's not working at the moment, but we'll call him a jazz deacon anyway because he is. Yeah.
He's sporting a good mustache, though.
Exactly.
Look at that.
Awesome mustache.
Yes. And this guy right here, piano player, trumpet player, idea man extraordinaire, Tim Wildman.
Mr. Preacher.
Don't tell Carol. I promised her I wouldn't have any more ideas.
Oh, sorry, Carol. Sorry. So sorry. Just a couple of other announcements as we begin our official worship. For those who have not yet been here, there are restrooms right through this door, as well as water fountains. There's also pitchers of waters to the... Waters? Sure. Pitchers of waters to the to your right, my left. And we invite you to remain, if you would like, following worship. We have... it's a mini Sunday, ice cream Sunday, with mini cups of ice cream, and we'd like you to stay and help us eat said mini cups of ice cream after worship. Yes, this worship service is a gift to all of you, and we invite you to pay it forward if you are so moved and able. There's a basket at the table for offerings. Also, wanted to make sure you note we are actually having a ceremony, a ritual for new members today during our service. We'll be remembering Ken, which is wonderful. And if anybody else would like to join First Congregational Church this afternoon, you are most welcome. The only requirements to maintain membership, get this, just so you know, it's small and tiny. You either need to go to one worship service a year or donate $1 a year or attend one other event that First Congregational does at any point in the year. So if you're interested, also, you can be an associate member, which means if you're a member of another faith community, you are welcome to remain a member of said faith community, as long as they're okay with it, and join ours as well, if you are interested. So we'll be doing that during worship today. Anything else I forgot? Oh, yes, and we have our newer Songs of Joy, or hymn, excuse me. Songs of Worship, that's what it's called. CDs available for purchase. And if you prefer digital versus CDs, you can purchase that album on your favorite musical online source, whether that's Spotify or Apple Music or Amazon, all of them. They're all on there.
You can list it for free.
You can, and we list it for free. Yeah, there's a question from the deacon in the back. Oh, yes, thank you. At our last summer concert series concert this coming Thursday. Thank you, Brenda. Hopefully outside, but with the way the weather's been, we may be right here in this room. From 6 to 7:15, we hope you'll join us for that as well. We're going to be playing more of our favorites. I know. Oh, right, I forgot that part. We're playing, we. So you can come and have a double dose of us this week. And we're if you can take it, with lots more. Anything else I forgot? Was good? Okay, all right. Then we're going to begin with our opening song, I Want Jesus to Go With Me. Original blessing from the book of Genesis in the Hebrew Scriptures, chapter 1. God saw everything that God had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that God had done, and he rested and was rejuvenated on the seventh day from all the work he had done. So God blessed the seventh day, the 24 hours in it, and hallowed it, because on it, in it, God rested from all the work that God had done in creation. Amen. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and for you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful Tim, I'm turning over these additional readings to you.
Yes, I was thinking about the reason that we are so fond of all of our favorites. Thinking about this, planning this, that many of us grew up at a time of top 40 radio when you heard the same tunes over and over and over again, mostly on AM radio. And so we all had this shared experience, and boy, did we listen to our faves over and over again. So that's sort of what got me to thinking about that whole dynamic of having favorite tunes. So this is what they say from brain science. Brain imaging studies show that our favorite songs stimulate the brain's pleasure circuit, which releases an influx of dopamine, serotonin, oxytocin, and other neurochemicals that make us feel good. And when we like a song or link it to some positive experience, it activates the reward system in our brain by releasing dopamine. Since the song makes us feel good and generates a pleasant feeling of comfort, it is normal that we want to listen to it again and again.
Amen. So we're going to invite you to join with us with this next one. Probably most of the folks in the room have now sung this with me, although you'll notice we've changed up the lyrics to line up with what we're doing today, at least a little bit. This is a song that I wrote, this was back at the beginning of my health journey. That's crazy. I wrote this and then I got COVID. Anyway, moving on. So, we're going to play it through first, and then I invite you to follow along with me. One, two, three, one, two, three. Nice, everybody. Thank you. So we've got two questions, and they're similar and different, that we invite you to reflect on, and then I'm going to turn it over to Tim to reflect.
Okay.
So what is your favorite song and why? And then nuanced, what is your favorite song to sing and or play and why? Which may or may not be the same song.
Mm. Wow. Yeah. I sort of liked what was in there about part of a favorite song. Sometimes is associations that we have in our life or that time when we first heard the song or when we became fond of it, that is tied to it. And so there are so many favorite songs from growing up, I'm sure that we all have. I think the first time I heard I Want to Hold Your Hand by the Beatles, it was in 1964. I was a senior in high school, and it seemed like the musical earth had shifted somehow. And it just seemed like half the songs on the radio were by the Beatles, and I Want to Hold Your Hand is the one that I remember the most. It was, you know, being a senior in high school is always an experience.
That's one word for it, yes.
Certainly was for me, as it is for everyone. So that's one that I think was a favorite when I was a kid, just to hear. I love so many of the songs that we play, but certainly the way you sing What a Wonderful World makes that just a... It has so many associations playing it and listening to it. You sing it so beautifully, and our friend who comes up many times in the fall from New Orleans, Delphiel Marsalis, often ends his concerts with it as a kind of musical benediction and an homage to famous New Orleans trumpet player and father of jazz, many people say Louis Armstrong, who first had the hit back in the 60s. So I think that's a favorite for me. There's so many rich associations with that, and the message of that original blessing from Genesis paired with What a Wonderful World is just, yeah, kind of does it for me.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. So we'd love to open the floor and hear about some other favorite songs. Again, your favorite song, just maybe bar none, and then maybe one that you like to sing or play, even if you think you don't sing or play it well, that doesn't stop you from loving to sing it or play it. So I just put in that caveat in there.
From time to time, I've gone through the New Century Hymnal looking for my favorite, and I always end up with about 40. I have yet to learn how to narrow it down to one. Now, about half of them, I think, could be done in jazz, but my question, and it's, I know it's kind of a naive one, are there other hymns that so far have not been done to a jazz style that you could improvise on and add to our list?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Don't give us ideas.
Oh, gosh, yeah. We're doing In the Garden later, which clearly is our improvisation on that. And then next to it was Now the Green Blade Rises, and I'm like, yeah, we could do that as a jazz 2-foot waltz. I mean, it would be, why not? So, yes, lots. Yeah. In fact, we
did Bach as a bossa nova a while back.
We did.
If you've done Bach as a bossa nova, you'll do anything.
Absolutely, yeah. Other favorite songs that people have?
One of our favorite songs is May I Have This Last Dance With You, sung by Ann Miller.
Yes.
It was a long time ago, Tim.
Yeah.
Gwen and I were students at West Virginia Wesleyan College.
Oh, wow.
And we would gather for good times and dancing at a place called the Scow, the Student Center of Wesleyan. And it actually was an old Quonset hut from the Second World War that they had made into a nice little gathering place. Oh. And I think it was the first time I tried to waltz with my wife, my wife-to-be.
Oh. And she married you anyway,
yeah.
Frank.
Yeah.
Thank you. That is so great.
Thank you, Frank.
By the way, Ron, you and Frank each went to BU School of Theology. I never knew that before.
Wow.
Yeah.
You guys will have to talk later. Yeah. This is all about community. We're trying to make connections for everybody. Other favorite songs?
For me, because I'm married to Tim, A Wonderful World is just, it hits my happy emotional center. Mm. So it's just an emotion, just a happy emotion.
Awesome.
So that is the one that I love to listen to, especially the Delphio connection and the hearing you sing it is just lovely for me. But also, I guess the Delphio thing holds a lot of weight for me, but Jazz Party, I love to sing, and I love to dance and move my body. So, you know, a lot of songs that I love to sing are about moving my body in whatever way I want to, that makes me happy.
Awesome. Thank you, Carol. There was, here in the middle? Yeah.
Hi, my favorite song would be As Time Goes By.
Oh, yeah.
See what happens? Everybody's serotonin just skyrocketed because you said that. Yeah.
And it reminds me of my father. It reminds me when I was a teenager when I discovered love and no one else knew anything about it. Just me. And then it reminds me also of my aunt, who I spent the last couple of years with. And we kissed all the time. And I'd kiss her, and she would just sigh. And it was just lovely. And I like it so much that I don't play the piano. I never had a lesson, but I learned. And it took me about 3 or 4 hours to get through it. By then, I had memorized it.
Wow.
So,
perfect.
That's great.
Yes, so it's one of the only songs I can.
Awesome.
When the gentleman was talking about being in college and going to a local, it brought back memories of being in college and going into what we called the hat rack. And Scotch and Soda was often playing on the jukebox.
Nice.
And it's just always stuck with me. And then after I met Jim, his brother Tom played sax and we'd do jazz at the Five. And he would play Scotch and Soda, and I would sing along with him. So that's one that's always stuck with me.
Awesome. Thank
you.
That's
great. Anybody who doesn't remember or didn't know Tom Kinnon, her brother-in-law, was a wonderful, wonderful sax player who often came back and had jam sessions.
I'm thinking of Sunrise, Sunset. And I just, it never fails to transport me to wonderful, wonderful imaginings.
Thank you, Susie. Over here.
Well, my all-time favorite is It's a Wonderful World, and we wake up to that every morning, and it just starts my day in a way that is positive. But another song that means a lot to me is Unforgettable, because my dad used to sing it, and he died 17 years ago, and it just touches a special place in my heart.
Thank you very much.
We should do that.
We've got a recording of it. It was like, we should make a list of these. Yeah. This sounds like a great set list, just saying.
This is great.
Other songs, and band members, feel free to jump in here if you guys want to share your, just like, I'll never pick. Two favoritist songs from my childhood were Maniac on the Floor. That song would come on and my whole body would start vibrating. This is what my mother tells me anyway. And when that eventually moved off the radio, it was very sad. I didn't find it again until much later, and now it's all over all my Pandora stations. And then a little bit later on, there was a song that would come on the radio, and I was like, what is this? And of course, I wasn't allowed to watch the movie that it goes along until much later. The theme to Beverly Hills Cop. Don't ask me why. As a junior high student, that just was it for me. So the synthesizer made it. There you are. But I think my all-time favorite song to sing... Oh, geez, let's see. When I Fall in Love is my all-time favorite song to sing. It was one of the first jazz songs I did when I started taking jazz songs and voice in college. And it's just, it makes me Makes me happy every time. Any other songs that you would like to share?
Well, it's kind of a different song in that I've always sung with choirs, but singing with the Concord Chorus, the Hallelujah, the Handel's Messiah. Yeah. When we get to the Hallelujah Chorus, Handel supposedly said that when he wrote that, he felt heaven's doors open. Mm. And, you know, I was often overcome with emotion, and of course you can kind of drop out when you're singing with 100 other people.
Yes.
But that's one of my favorites.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Eleanor. Yeah. I mean, we could do that up here, guys. What do you think? Hallelujah Chorus on bass, drums, and saxophone?
Sure.
Excellent. Well, thank you all very much. I don't know if you can tell, my dopamine is flowing now, so it's amazing how much even just naming some of these songs will bring us into that space of favorites. We're going to do another classic one here, and I realize we didn't put the lyrics in the bulletin, but I'm pretty sure you know the song, so feel free to join in with us in Lean On Me. Who wish to unite with this particular community of faith. That includes Ken and anybody else who would like to. All right. Thank you for joining me. By your baptism, you were made one with us in the body of Christ, the church, literally in this congregation. Today we rejoice in your pilgrimage of faith that has brought you back to this time and to this place. We give thanks for every community of faith that has been or continues to be your spiritual home, and we celebrate your presence in this community of faith. And so now, Ken, I ask you, do you promise to participate in the life and mission of this family of God's people, sharing regularly in the worship of God and enlisting in the work of this local congregation as it serves this community and the world? And if so, I invite you to respond, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
Thank you, Ken. And now I invite the members of First Congregational Church of Concord to join me in expressing our welcome and our mutual interest ministry in Christ. I invite you to rise in body or spirit. And will the members of First Church join with me in saying, we welcome you with joy in the common life of this congregation. We promise you our friendship and prayers as we share the hopes and labors of the Church of Jesus Christ. By the power of the Holy Spirit, may we continue to grow together in God's knowledge and love as we live out the mission of Jesus Christ. So in the name, please be seated. In the name of Jesus Christ and on behalf of First Congregational Church of Concord, can we extend to you the celebratory hands of Christian love, welcoming you into the company of this local congregation. Shake your hand, and I give you your membership, and I ask all of our members and anybody else to join me in welcoming Ken after our service, especially during our ice cream social. So I invite you to be seated, and then I'm going to bring us into a space of prayer, and yes, feel free to applaud Tim. Thank you, yes. Thank you so much, Ken. It's a joy to have you back in this congregation. So let us be together in a spirit of prayer. Oh God, we praise you for calling us to faith and for gathering us into the body of Christ. We thank you for your people gathered in this local congregation and rejoice that you have filled our community of faith with love and joy, creativity, imagination, and passion for mission and outreach. Together, may we live in the Spirit, building one another up in love, sharing in the life and worship of this community, and serving the world in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And I'm going to turn it over to Tim for further affirmations.
Yes, I want to affirm that we are all partners, whether we are in the more traditional sense or not, members of this church or any church. We have felt from the beginning of the Jazz Sanctuary Ministry over 8 years ago that whenever we gather, we are partners in a community. And I love the word partnership because it's an active word. It's a faith word. It's that we are involved not in just being members of something, but in being partners in a community where we seek to be with each other and be with the Spirit and to care for each other and to care for the world in God's name. So I want to affirm that as Ken is the newest and perhaps oldest returning member of the First Congregational Church, that we are all partners together, and I want to affirm that in this space, and that whenever we gather, we are once again partners together, and that we take that partnership with us out into the world. So
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Tim. And so let us join together now in partnership in prayer in that specific way. I'm going to open it up for space for a moment of silence to really listen for God in our hearts, and then I'm going to invite us to lift up popcorn style, whatever prayers are on your heart. We won't be passing around the microphone, so this is from your lips to God's ears and those people around you. And then I will lead us in a pastoral prayer and finally invite us to join together in the version of the Lord's Prayer that we pray together at Jazz Sanctuary, which is translated from the Aramaic by Neil Douglas-Klotz. So let us begin together with a moment of silence to listen for God in our hearts. Gracious and loving God, or as I often refer to you, Papa, we ask that you hear now the prayers that we have brought with us this morning, prayers of joys, prayers of concerns, either aloud as they are spoken and lifted up, or in our hearts, knowing that you hear those as well. Oh God, we know because we have experienced that praise is contagious. Like an epidemic, its location spreads from earth to heaven. Like a pandemic, its motive spreads from what the Lord has done to who the Lord is. There's not an instrument that remains unaffected. Trumpet, harp, cymbals, and voice are swept up in praise. There's not a human or creature who remains immune. Everything that breathes catches the bug to sing hallelujah. May no cure ever be found for the contagion that is praise. And now I invite you to join with me in the Lord's Prayer as is printed in your bulletin. O birther, father, mother of the cosmos, focus your light within us, make it useful. Create your reign of unity now through our fiery hearts and willing hands. Help us love beyond our ideals and sprout acts of compassion for all creatures. Animate the earth within us. We then feel the wisdom underneath supporting all. Untangle the knots within so that we can mend our hearts' simple ties to each other. Don't let surface things delude us, but free us from what holds us back from our true purpose. Out of you, the astonishing fire, returning light and sound to the cosmos. Amen.
Still on the roses and the voice.
Here we go. Preparing for the Agape Feast, my friends. This is a table and a place and a space and a time of welcome. All are free to come and to eat. As we gather in this space and as we continue in worship, we remember these words of our brother Jesus. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst.
We come to this table hungry and thirsty, seeking to be satisfied. As we gather at this table, we remember these words of our brother Jesus. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest.
We come to this table, this place, weary and burdened, seeking rest. As we gather at this table, we remember that Jesus comes to us in those who are strangers to us, in those who are hungry, in those who are thirsty, and in those either needing warmth or to be cooled down.
We come to this table as strangers in a strange land. We ask with humble confidence that you welcome us into your family, O God.
And we ask you now to join with us in praying the prayer of adoration. Living God, you are present in our midst, and we praise you. You are tearing down walls of alienation and exclusion. For this, we praise you, because in Jesus, you have shown us a way of hospitality, simplicity, prayer, peacemaking, and resistance. Because your Spirit makes a new path for us, as we struggle to live in the shadow of doubt and fear, weak as we are, you fill us with hope. Lover of our souls, you give us joy, and we praise you. Amen. And so we take joy in this meal, where we give our love and our attention to one another, and remember that Jesus, too, is here with us, giving us love and attention. In the midst of this sacred meal and this sacred practice, we set three symbols, one of which continues to be metaphorical, to remind us of Jesus's promises to us.
A metaphorical candle never goes out. A candle to remind us that Jesus poured out his Holy Spirit upon us, giving us new life, new power, and new hope. We, filled with this Spirit, bring the presence of God into a broken world.
And bread. For Jesus is the bread of life. He nourishes us, and we put our trust in him.
Grapes, a reminder of his struggle for justice and peace, a reminder of his suffering at the hands of the Roman Empire. He suffers still when the oppressed suffer injury at the hands of the powerful.
Jesus is with us in this Agape Feast. He's in our hearts. We already sang this. I am in Christ. And Christ is in me. We are in Christ, and Christ is in us. So let us open our hearts to God and to one another as we share in this feast. Our deacons will come around, and as I share a lot, we welcome you to eat the bread first, if you would like, and then the grapes. Or you can do what Tim does and just eat them all at once and have the explosion of combination of flavors that happens between the salty and the sweet. The saltiness of life, the sweetness of life, it's all good mashed together. All things are now ready, so we invite you to eat as your food, Tim, to you, as your food comes to you. Do you want a hand?
No, I can.
You're okay. I'm going to offer our benediction, which is based on Psalm 145, and then we're going to invite you to join us in singing our sending music. As you go from here, remember this: the God we serve is merciful and fiercely compassionate, endlessly patient, thank you, Jesus, and full of faithful love. God is trustworthy in all that God says and faithful in all that God does. So go out in confidence, knowing that God goes with you to transform lives through you. Amen. So I've actually got a verse to share for this song. I didn't know. I was looking up on Google. Turns out there's a verse to this song. So I'm going to I'm going to say it, and then Joey's going to kick us off when Joey's ready.
This is a very complicated song to sing.
Very.
We would like you to do do-a. There's eight of them. We're going to count them, okay?
Yeah.
That's all you need to know.
You ready? What good is melody? What good is music if it ain't possessing something sweet? Nah, it ain't the melody, and it ain't the music. There's something else that makes this tune complete. Feel free to get up and dance.
If it's sweet or hot,
just give that rhythm everything that you've got.
It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing.
Do what, 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 do what.
Truly da boopy da boopy da boop ba 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 ba. Bow, 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 bow.
Ice cream.